Hey everybody, we are about to do the planner layout for next week, January 11th through 17th. This is my plum paper 7x9 vertical priorities layout planner in the neutral color scheme. Here was last week, if you may remember. We used this sort of Christmas and snowman theme. And I think for this week, we're going to go with coffee. I have made PDFs. I have an app on my phone where you can take photographs and then turn them into PDFs. And then I did that and just printed it out so that I could sort of sketch up my design. And I'm going to be using several different stamp sets. So for the coffee decorations, we're going to go with two sets from Sweet Stamp Shop. That's the SSS. Sweet Stamp Shop is unfortunately no longer in business, but you may be able to find these stamps out there for sale. This is called Coffee Town. It's got this cute little coffee house, and I think I'm gonna make it so that it looks like it's in a snowdrift with snow on the top. And then it's got this big thing that says coffee and these cute little word things. I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna use this other Sweet Stamp Shop set called Cup of Coffee. The Daily Grind, I'm gonna use that as my heading for each day's tasks. I think that's kind of cute. And then we have several different cups of coffee, and we have different types of coffee, and we have these little smiley faces. You can hear my cat who that can go on the cups. And then I'm going to also use some elements from this. Here we go, it's upside down. This is from Studio L2E. And this set is called Morning Cup. It's got little coffee beans, and I was going to use check boxes for all of my to-dos, but I might use little coffee beans and check maybe like this one or maybe this one in a light color to check over. And then it's got this I drink coffee for your protection and just a whole bunch of smaller coffee cups. And I'm thinking what I might do is at the bottom of the left side page is where I'll put the little coffee house with the snow and some snow on the roof. I may or may not put those little word cup coffee things around it. On the right side, I think I want to take that big word coffee and probably move it over a little bit, stick the I love in front of it. And then I don't know, maybe we'll see. And then at the top left, I'm going to use that I drink coffee for your protection stamp, and then all the different cups of coffee up there. The top right will be my gratitude section as usual. I say as usual, I've done it 1 week. But for it's worked out well. So for that, I'm going to use this stamp set from Coco Daisy. This came in the November 2020 Acorn Lane kit, and it has this grateful stamp right here. So I'm going to put that one right up here in the corner. And then just through the week, I just fill this box up with things that I'm grateful for. And then for my meal planning, I'm going to do my meal planning again in these middle boxes. And this is actually like a plate and utensil stamp right here. And this is also Sweet Stamp Shop Plan to Eat. So I like that to mark off my meals. And then on the weekend, I'm going to use a stamp for planning my next layout. I think I may use this set, College Plans, from Sweet Stamp Shop. This stamp is really big, but I like it. It's very cute. I may use one of the smaller ones, maybe the lamp or just the binder clip. We'll see. But I'll use that to delineate my planning. And then on Sunday for my chores, I'm going to use these two sets from, again, Studio L2E. This is Iconic and Iconic Activities. And we've got here the little shirt that I use to show that I have to do laundry. There is a little trash can and a little recycling right there. And I was looking, they've got some sports icons on this one, but no hockey. I've got to figure out a way to show hockey because the Caps, I'm a Capitals fan, and the Caps are starting their season on Thursday the 14th, and there's a game on Thursday, Friday, and Sunday, and I would love to have some cute little thing to delineate that. I'll have to dig through my stamp sets and see if I can find anything that would work for that. But this is the plan. I think I'm going to use shades of like pink and brown to color in, and yeah. This is the plan. We'll see how it comes together. I'm going to fast forward you through and then show you at the end how it turns out. All right. So I'm going to voice over for you now what is happening. I want to make my little coffee house and the word coffee that I'm going to put in, I want them to look like they're in the winter with snow. So what I'm using here is called masking paper. And what you do is you stamp your stamp on it, and then you cut out the parts that you want to show. And then when you put the, you stick the paper down, it's got a sticky backside, and so it sticks down. And then you restamp, and you can see that the top and the bottom are missing, and this is where I can draw in now my snow. Stamp masking paper. I'll try to remember to link it down below so you can see it. It is really handy when you want to have part of your, only stamp part of your stamp and not the whole thing. It's very helpful also for like if you want to layer stamps, you want to make one look like it's in front of the other, but you don't want to be able to see through the top one to the back one. It can be used for a lot of cool things. So I've trimmed off the top of the word coffee, and then now I'm going to just stamp over the part that I can see. And then when I peel up that stamp paper, you see that the top part is gone and I can draw in the snow at the top. So, you know, since it's January, it's winter, we want to kind of make it look like it's wintry and snowy. I don't know where you guys live, but I'm about half an hour south of Washington, D.C. And although it's winter, we don't have any snow right now. Boo-hoo. But I'm hoping for it. So there you go. Now I'm putting my decorative part up at the top. I drink coffee for your protection. I love that stamp set. Please excuse my head getting in the way with all this stamping. And I just decided to fill up the rest of the box with different shapes of coffee cups and coffee mugs from the various stamp sets. I'll link any of the stamp sets that are still available and can still be purchased down below. Anything from Sweet Stamp Shop. They are no longer in business, so you'll have to go looking for them maybe on like Etsy or other craft BST groups. The Grateful Stamp is from Coco Daisy, and it fits well in that box up there. So here I am pulling all the words off of these two stamp sets, and I was going to put them like around the coffee house and around the word coffee, and then I just sort of decided they would make a cool border across the bottom instead. And I really, really like how that turned out. That made me very happy. It's like, you know, coffee please, coffee more, coffee first. And then there's like, you know, cappuccino, Americano. I really like how that sort of filled up the bottom where the snowbanks are. So it wasn't just sort of empty space. That part turned out well. And it even was awesome that it turned out that everything fit pretty much exactly. I hadn't measured it out ahead of time, and the words fit exactly in those gray boxes, which is pretty awesome. So, the next thing that I'm going to do here is, I'm putting little smiley faces on the coffee cups. I'm getting ready to put stamp like a zillion of the little coffee beans, which I talked about in my plan. And I wish now that I had not done it. This is something I do not like how this turned out. I wish I had just used my little check boxes like normal. It was hard to get the coffee beans lined up just right. It was, and there's my head again, I'm sorry. And then there's so many of them, I just feel like they're so like in your face. I just do not like how this looks. So lesson learned. I will go back to check boxes from now on, but I'll just have to deal with this as I go. You see, I accidentally stamped one on Tuesday and then realized I had intended to alternate pink and brown. So then I had to I'll stamp over that one in a minute with brown, and it won't cover it exactly, and so that's going to irritate me. And then you'll see something else that I did that was not to my plan. You see how on the bottom columns, how I left the top line empty? Well, that stamp right there, the Daily Grind, was supposed to go in that space. And I'm like, oh, crap. Okay, well, now it's going to go in that upper space. I mean, I had the plan, you guys, the plan on the pages was right there next to me. I just didn't follow it exactly. Ugh, made me so mad. Anyway. So yeah, see these, the coffee beans. Ugh, I just don't like how they look. I do not like how they look. I think the pages look better once I start writing things in and those beans aren't like in your face. But you see how they're uneven. They're not all facing exactly the same direction. It just did not work out the way that I wanted it to. So lesson learned, like I said, I'll go with the check boxes from now on. I'm putting in my plate and utensil stamp for meal planning. I'm going to put some stamps over on the right side. That one is to remind me to plan next weekend. And then I'm going to put in my chore stamps on Sunday. There's the trash can and the recycling and the little shirt to remind me to do laundry. And then here's a stamp that I was super excited about. I found in one of my stamp sets that has sports in it, this little hockey puck. And that's exciting because I'm a huge Capitals fan, and the Caps are, hockey is coming back this week, and the Caps are playing their opening game on Thursday. And I was excited to find that little hockey puck stamp so that I can notate the Caps games in my planner. And now it's time just to go ahead and color and finish the decoration. I'm using my Prismacolor colored pencils in, like I said, shades of pink and brown. And pink and brown is one of my favorite combos, and I just really like how it turned out. It's warm, but also kind of cool at the same time, I guess. I don't know what I'm talking about. but the coffee house, putting the lights in the coffee house window so it looks like, you know, someplace warm and cozy that you want to go. I really did like how the coffee house turned out. And then the word coffee over on the other page turned out good, I thought. I like to use a little bit of blue to shadow the snow. And then I'm going to also here color the cups up top with the same pink and brown. What's the word I want? Color scheme. There you go. This is my, this will be my second week in this layout. And it worked so well for me last week. I am like, this is the layout that I've been looking for my whole life and didn't realize I was missing. I just absolutely love this layout. It is so perfect. So here we go. Now I'm writing some things in. I do think the coffee beans don't look quite so bad with stuff written in. And as I put check marks over them, they'll disappear a little bit more. I think I'll end up liking that better. I'm putting in everything that's scheduled, and then the bottom part is where I list my to-dos every day as they come up. And here you go. Here's the finished product. Love that little coffee shop and those words. I think that turned out so well. The coffee sign there, the little hockey puck, and then the upper part. Those coffee beans kind of almost look like lips too, and that's bothering me as well. Hey, you know what? Next week is a new week, right? Anyway, thank you so much for being with me. Please feel free to leave any questions or comments down below, and I will see you next time. Bye.